Perfect. What's number four about? Oh, is that the rocket?
No, the oil one.
Did you watch the video?
Yeah, but I don't understand, like, why poop or
sleep. Okay, here's the deal. I will do that one, but after I do other ones, because I want to do some recent topics too. So. Yes.
Simple question.
Simple question, okay.
So simple.
So simple, okay, go on. What's the question?
Is vacation easy?
The cantilever, where's the fourth point which we should consider? Yeah, so for both of these,
yeah.
You've got, let me see, weight.
Yeah.
Weight.
Yeah.
Here, tension here.
Yeah, tension here.
And here,
tension.
Well, it's not clear, like it could be here. Yeah. Oh, sorry, it could, you see, this one's a bit different because this is like a table.
Yeah.
So it's pushing it up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's push.
Push up.
Yeah.
Now, it depends on how it's connected here.
Yeah.
So if it's like this, where it's just resting on top,
yeah,
then the force will be straight up.
Yeah.
But maybe if it's, you know what I mean, like, attached, like with a screw, then the force could be out.
Like this,
yeah,
way?
Yeah, 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 like this.
You mean, in the top situation?
Yeah.
I feel, yeah, if this is smooth,
yeah,
no friction, smooth,
yeah, yeah,
then it'll only be this way.
Yeah.
But if you put a screw here,
yeah,
it could be this way, yeah. Now I think in my picture in the book it's I have no, it's free.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. So that's what I wanted here.
Here.
Yeah, and the reaction is always here and here.
Here.
Out and out.
This. Yep. This because
yep.
This is.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. That's
box.
It. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
This is box.
Yeah.
Box.
Yeah.
Box. Box.
Yeah.
Box.
Here.
Yeah.
Because there's one this way and one this way.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah.
Same here.
Yeah.
One this way and one this way.
We don't consider this point.
It's not important. We just care about here and here.
Just
so, yeah.
Where's tension here? Just this?
No, it's the other way because this is a string, so it's pulling up, and this is a support, so it's pushing.
No,
I already had lunch.
Oh,
no, they wouldn't mind if I went down to Tesco. They'd wait for me.
No.
You guys would wait for me, wouldn't you?
No.
That's it, yep.
Yeah.
Okay, what's next now? Guys over here, what questions do you need me to do that were causing you a problem? Is that the cannon? Yeah. Okay, that's a good one. Can we all go to the page on work? I'm going to have a look at number six. Can you see that? Okay, great. Can you give me the info, please? What's the story saying? Okay, let me just draw that. 5.4 kilograms. Like this?
Yes.
And do I give an angle?
Yes, 5 degrees.
Okay. How much work?
The length of the cannon barrel is
1.91 meters. Okay, and what is the work done by the cannon? So, what is this cannon doing to the cannonball? So the ball starts here, and then it ends here, and exits. So during this 1.91 meters, what was that doing to the cannonball? What form of energy? What do you think? Yeah, what type of energy? Potential and
kinetic.
So here the ball was at rest and on the ground. Here it's moving quite fast and it's above the ground. However, because this is only 5 degrees, I won't consider the potential energy since it's too small. If you do consider it, you'll still get basically the same answer. In fact, it might even be exactly the same because it's going to be a very small value here. 5 degrees is nearly ground level. So, five degrees is not much. It's not much. So here it has kinetic energy. Here it has kinetic and potential. Here it has only kinetic. Yeah. So I think what I would like to do is just to say that the work done, which is the force by the distance, that should equal the kinetic energy of the ball. Now the problem is, I don't know how fast it's going here, do I? I don't. So I'm nearly finished, but annoyingly, I can't finish it because I don't know the V. So now I have to work out the V. Now, how can I work out the V? What will give me the V? Well, I can work backwards because I know the range here. Okay, so let me work backwards. First, let me get the time. I could say, using my triangle here, distance, speed, and time. Where's distance? Distance equals speed, which would be u cos 5 multiplied time. Now why am I saying u cos 5? Where's that coming from? From, yeah, this part here. Yeah. Now, that's not great because I have two things I don't know. Okay, so now let me look at the vertical direction. I can say S, which is 0, equals U T plus a half A T squared. Yeah? Now that's actually not too bad because I have two equations and I have two unknowns, but it's actually a little bit better because I can cancel a T here. So I could actually rewrite this as, let's see, if I cancel out my T, I can say U sine 5 over 4.905, that's equal to T. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so how can I use this and this? Well, maybe if I just take the first one and also do something similar, I can say T equals 1480 over U cos 5. Now if you look at this, I got this from looking at the X, and if you look at this, I got that from looking at the Y. I can put these together to find U.
Yeah.
And if I can find the U, then I'm finished. Because this here says work, which is force by distance, is a half M, whatever that U squared is. So let me make these equal and see what I get. U sine 5 over 4.905 equals 1480 over U cos 5. Okay, so I'll rearrange this. I'll bring the U up here and make it U squared. So I'll get U squared equals 1480 times 4.905 over cos 5 sine 5. Now, you might say, okay, now I need to square root it, but why bother square rooting it? Because I actually do need U squared. And am I asking for the work or the force? Probably the force. Oh, the work? Not the force? Okay. So work equals a half M U squared. That's one way to do it. And of course there are other ways to do it. It's just one way to do it. We didn't? Ah, so there's another way to do it then. Yeah, yeah. So let's have a look at another way to do it. this is okay, this method here, but what's another way of doing it without KE? Let's go back up. Well, I can still get this result here without using KE, because there was no KE or PE here. This is just about the using the information about how far it travels. So let's see if we can do this another way, but without using the KE and the PE. Right, so what do I wanted the work done. So the work is the force by the distance, okay? Now I know the distance, what was it, 1.91 in the canon, and I have a law for F from Newton, that's MA 1.91. Do I know the M? I do. Do I know the distance? I do. So the only thing I need to know is the A. And I do know the A, because the ball starts here at rest, and then later it's going this fast, square root of that number. I'll just put a little star here, so I don't have my calculator open. Okay, so how can I get the A? V minus U over, no, not that one, because we don't know the T. V squared equals U squared plus 2AS, would that one work? V squared, yeah, that one would work, wouldn't it? V squared, which I know, equals U squared, which I know, plus 2AS. I know the 2 and the S. Yeah, so I can get the A here and put it into that. This is 0, and the V is just whatever that number is in the calculator. Actually, I don't need to square root it, because again, it's a V squared. Okay, what's the M? 5 point something, isn't it? 5.4 times 1.91 times A, and A will be V squared over 2S. Okay. 2S. And then the V squared, which is 1480 times 4.905 over cos 5, sine 5. No, I don't think I need the square, because I needed V squared in my formula, and this is it here. I know, I'm sorry, I'm mixing up how I'm using my letters, because earlier I was saying this was U, because I was looking at the journey. But now when I look at the canon, this is actually V, and this is now U. This question is a bit tricky, I know, but it's a little bit easier to do now that we have kinetic energy. And of course in the exam, that, of course you can do it that way, because you've covered everything in the exam. So if you just want to do it how I was doing earlier, by looking at the kinetic energy, it's a tiny bit easier. Okay. Who was asking me that one? Was it you? Or was you yet? Any better? Yeah, it's a bit of a mess, isn't it? You can read this.
U cos 5 is the white fat from the white planet.
Yeah, okay. If you want me to be technical about it, yeah. U cos 5, U sine 5. Yeah. Is that good or bad? Be honest. Why is it bad? Here. Which is, it's the same thing as here. Is that worse?
It's hard.
Oh yeah. Well, I never told you I would give you easy questions. I never said that. Technically it's not, because the canon has a small height. But this height's going to be tiny, it's going to be just a couple of centimeters. Like maybe 10 centimeters off the ground. And when you're talking about a canon that fires a cannonball 1480 meters, that 10 centimeters at the beginning, it's just going to be a pain to consider it, and it's not going to make your answer any more accurate. So I'm deliberately ignoring the fact that the cannon has a length when I'm doing the projectile part. But obviously I can't ignore that the cannon has a length when I'm doing the work part, because the work is done over that length. So I'm very, very deliberately changing the picture to make it easier for me, because I know such a small height is not going to matter much in the projectile calculation, but of course I can't ignore it in the work calculation. Now, if you don't like doing things like that, you don't feel happy doing that, then you can consider this height in the projectile part, but then realize what you're doing. Here, when I said S is zero, you can't say that anymore. You'd have to say, if the cannon starts here, you'd have to say S is like minus 10 centimeters or something. That then, you realize, makes this harder, which then makes this harder, and so on and so on. And why bother if it's not going to change the answer? You know? Yeah. I don't know. Are you happy with this? Yeah, that means no. I'm so sorry. Okay, what's the next question then?
Simple question.
Another simple question. I like simple questions. Go on.
When I write the answer.
Yeah.
How many?
Three.
How many?
Three. I'm giving you the answer. I know what you're going to ask me. The answer is 3SF.
Yeah.
Yeah. So like this. 6.21.
How did you know?
I have a secret. I'm secretly an X-Man.
And
my mutant power is I can read minds. But only minds of students.
How did you know? Yeah. Oh.
I know everything.
Thank you.
Oh, no problem. Okay, next question. What's next? Now you need to give me another question, or I'm going to have to do that wait and dry question.
You know, you remember the diagram set?
Yes. Which one?
Cantilever.
Oh, the cantilever.
And the cantilever part. This question.
Which one?
It's like this question.
Do I remember it? Which one is that?
Oh, why did you remember?
Which one are you talking about? Oh, that?
Yeah, then.
Yeah. You want me to do that one?
And the question is just like it is in this.
Let me draw.
T-shirt.
One sec. I just want to see what his question is. Yeah. Okay. What's your question?
Yeah. Is it possible to put the turning point anywhere?
Yeah. Anywhere.
Anywhere.
As long as you use the same point for the whole question, it's fine.
Fine.
Yeah. Okay.
To, like, for the cantilever, we just need to focus on
the actual thing that's hanging. Yeah.
Not the platform.
Yeah, like when you're looking at the cantilever, you only really care about the forces on it. You don't care about any other forces on the rest of the system. Yeah.
Question 5, what kind of
dampers is that the pump question? No. Which one is that? Which one?
50 gram lead weight is hanging on the pendulum.
Ah, the pendulum one. Yeah, okay, let's do that one. Guys, we're going to have a look now at the kinetic and potential lesson at number 5. Can you look at that?
Yeah.
Okay. There's a pendulum. How long is the pendulum?
1 meter.
Okay, 1 meter. And there's a mass at the end of it, 50 grams. Okay. And my question, I can probably guess it right now, is how fast is it going when it's here? The V. Yeah. Okay. And I think you were asking me this the last time, weren't you? You asked me something about this, yeah. Okay. So let's have a look at this one. Now, before I even start, I need to work out some distances. So, Let me just draw a triangle here. Right. This is 1 meter. This angle here, do I provide it? 10 degrees, okay. So this side here, this will be 10, oh sorry, it won't be, it'll be 1 cos 10. And this side here will be 1 sine 10. So this height here will be 1 minus 1 cos 10. Because the whole thing is 1, and this is 1 cos 10. Yeah?
If they are still hanging on to a pendulum of length 1 meter, how would I know if it's that is 1 meter or that is 1 meter?
Whoops! What did I do? Huh? How would you know which is 1 meter?
Like, how I know is it that 1 meter or that
1 meter? Oh, or 1 meter. Yeah, because it's just one pendulum going like this. Yeah, this way, yeah. Is that, that's what I asked for, I think. Was it the maximum speed? Yeah. Yes, which will be in the centre, yeah. The pendulum isn't going to change its length. So, continue?
Yeah.
Right, so what can we say here? We can say, okay, what energy does it have here? It only has potential. And here, only has kinetic. Now you actually realize, although I told you the mass, you don't actually need the mass.
Yeah.
So the V is square root 2gh. So the V is square root 2gh. Whatever that is on the calculator. What's the answer at the back for this one? I'll just write it down.
0.545.
545? Ah, that's ugly. I'll say 54.5 centimeters per second. That's nice. Is that okay? That one?
Where is the maximum speed point?
At the bottom. Always. So here the pendulum's at rest, then it gets faster, fastest, slower, stopped.
Stopped?
Yep. And stopped.
Direction is opposite.
Yep.
Mm.
Yep. Mm. The sound effects are helpful. Yes. That sounds more like a transformer than a pendulum, you know? Optimus Prime.
I don't like transformers.
What? You don't like transformers? You don't like Transformers or the Transformer movies?
Movies.
Because I can understand not liking the movies.
Movie I do like.
The Transformers are cool.
Yeah.
I used to watch the cartoon as a kid.
No.
You never watched the cartoon?
No.
I miss them. Recently I'm watching, I downloaded the X-Men cartoon. From the 1990s. I remember it as a kid. And then a week ago he said, I think I'll download all the episodes and watch them again. Classic cartoons from the 90s. Can't beat them.
No, Scooby-Doo.
Scooby-Doo, give me a break, would you? X-Men? Batman?
Oh, no. Batman.
Good. Yeah. He-Man?
What?
He-Man?
He-Man's
a classic. You know He-Man? Johnny Bravo is also good. Yeah. Do you know any of these cartoons? You do? Yes.
Yeah, but
in Arabic. Batman in Arabic. I'd love to see that.
And even like anime, are you watching
in Arabic? Great. Do they try to keep the voice the same, or is close to the English one? Because I sometimes find with when they do the translation, I'm always thinking, they didn't even try to get someone with the same voice, you know? Like, it's totally different.
Question.
Yes.
Simple question.
Another, oh, great! I took these simple questions. Go on.
I thought that our weight
yes?
It includes the gravity.
Yeah? What do you mean?
My weight is...
Yeah.
My weight number is just because of gravity.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah, correct.
Why in physics mg?
Yeah, weight is mg, correct. And this is newtons, and this is kilograms, and this is meters per second squared. So this, you are right, this is only because of the g. It will be different in different planets. But this never changes.
Yeah, never changes.
Yeah.
And gravity changes.
Correct.
Yeah. Wherever we are.
Wherever we are, yeah. It only really matters on your height.
Yeah.
So the G is a little bit smaller up here than down here.
Yeah.
But on average, it's 9.81 meters per second squared.
Really?
It's only an average. On an average, yeah. You can actually measure the difference between ground level and, say, on a flight. You could actually measure the difference. It's actually not... It is a small difference, but it's big enough to see. It's something like a difference of maybe this. And that's you can easily measure that. You know, it's not that small of a difference. Okay, what's the next question now? Are we going to do that drag question? No questions means you're really smart and had no problems.
No, I'm a Christian.
Or you didn't try them, or you're too shy.
Everything.
Or all.
Oh, this is.
Which one?
40.
Yeah. Which question number?
5.
The last one?
Yeah.
I'll do that one.
It's good.
You like this?
No. Hard.
Right.
I think.
What page is that? That is Lamy's three-force theorem. What page?
33.
Yeah, this one, huh? Do you have any luck with it? You haven't watched it? And? Okay. Will we do this one now? Did you do this one?
No.
Ah, okay. Right. Have a look here, please. What do I tell you? I must tell you how high this is, right? Do I give you a height here? It's 4?
Yeah.
Okay. And do I tell you the radius here?
10 centimeters.
Oh, these are centimeters?
Yeah.
Okay. 10 centimeters.
Ten
right.
10 kilograms.
And 10 kilograms.
Yeah.
Okay. So, if this is 10 kilograms, it means here to here is a force 10 g. And I think I said in the question there's a force going this way of F.
Yeah.
Now, because of Lamy's three-force theorem, the force that's here must point to the center. And that's really helpful, because it means that if you look at this distance and this distance here, we can know these. We know this one's 4 centimeters. What's the radius of this? Is it 10 centimeters?
10.
So that means that's 6 centimeters. But this is a 10.
Yeah.
If I draw the triangle in the middle,
yeah.
This is a 6 and this is a 10.
8.
So that must be an 8 from Pythagoras. So, for this triangle here, we actually can know the angle, this angle we can know.
Yeah.
So, with that, I can say, this is or, I can say or cos theta equals F, and then or sine theta equals 10 g. The up one here equals the down, and the left equals the right. And I also know theta, because I can say theta is tan inverse 6 over 8. So, let's have a look at this. Do we know theta?
Yeah.
Yes. Do we know sine theta?
Yeah.
Yes. Do we know 10 g?
Yeah.
Yes. So, can we know or? Yeah. Now, do I know or? Now I do.
Yeah.
Do I know cos theta? I do. So can I know f? I can. And so it's solved. Just like that.
Easy.
Nice. I make it look easy.
Yeah.
How? I'm quite good at what I do. That's how. You must also remember, I'm the one who made these questions. I have an advantage.
Question is, how can you use the point and the vector direction?
In general or for this?
For this. Or in general.
The key is, I don't know if you missed this lesson, but there's a rule, it's called Lamy's theorem, that says if you have three forces, they all must point to the same point. So for example, if I have something like this, and there's a force here,
yeah.
We'll call it A,
yeah.
And there's a force here, we'll call it B, I know which way C must be, because Lamy said that the three forces, they must always point and meet at the same point. So in this picture, I know the weight is this way.
Mm.
I know the force is this way.
Mm.
So the oar must point to the center. This is Lamy's theorem. And it's a very useful theorem. And as we were saying last time, this is Lamy's only formula.
Only Lamy.
This is all that Lamy did. He did one thing and this was it. Very useful. Very useful. Okay. What's next?
Conservation of momentum.
Great.
Number 5.
Right, read it to me. Conservation of momentum number 5. What have we got? Go.
A bullet of a mass 80 gram is fired at 220 meters per second into a
1 kg rocket. Is this the one that swings up?
Yep.
Nice. Say no more. I know what the story is. Okay. So, here we have a bullet. The bullet is fired.
Yeah.
Enters the block, and as a result, the block swings up.
Elastic?
Could be, yeah. Could be inelastic. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. And it's my question, what's the height? Yeah, so what's the height here? Okay. So, when we look at this picture, are we looking at a problem that needs conservation of momentum, or are we looking at a problem that needs conservation of energy? No. Now, how can we know?
By using conservation.
Yeah, but that's for this part. Oh, you're looking. What did I ask for the A part?
A part is velocity.
Yeah. So that's what I was talking about here. In part A, you need the conservation of momentum to get the velocity after the bullet enters the block. And you're saying that part's okay, is it? Because we're on the B part. So can you just give me your answer then so I can use it? What did you get here? 60.3 meters. 16.3 meters per second. Okay, so now it swings up to a height. Right, so what energy does it have here when it starts the swing? Yeah. And up here when it stopped?
Potential.
So, a half, what's the mass we say? 80 grams. Oh no, but it's not just 80, it's also the block. How big is the block? What's the mass of the block?
1.8.
So this is 1.08.
Yep.
This feels like you found your mistake. 16.3 squared equals m. Oh, actually, I don't care about the m. because whatever it is, I cancel it anyways. So the H will be 16.3 squared over 19.62. That's the 2G. I just brought the G underneath with the 2. 16, what's that, about 18 meters or something? No, sorry, what am I saying? What is it about? Somewhere between 10 and 20 meters, I know that. Did you hit and type it in, or tell me the answer at the back?
13.94.
Yeah, 13.9 meters then. What was confusing you with this one now? I saw you rub out something. Was it this?
Yeah.
Was this not the same as this?
I thought that at first the math is 0.08, and then another one is 1.08.
Ah. But this 16.3, do you use that?
No, I use 13.
Good. No, this is a very good question. Guys, dude in the middle.
What?
Yeah. You, listen. I have a very good question now. Here I said the kinetic energy here equals the potential energy here. You looked at the kinetic energy here and said it's the same as the potential energy here, right? That actually gives you the wrong answer, but it's not clear why. Why would it be wrong to do this?
The difference of that.
Yes, but... Huh? Correct, but why is that a problem? Yeah. Well, there's many, many reasons. Probably the nicest one is what you said. We already saw previously when we're looking at collisions that it's possible that the kinetic energy is not conserved. So in fact, the kinetic energy here and here could be different. In fact, I expect this to be smaller than this, because maybe some heat was lost during the collision. So you can't say that the energy here and here is the same, because in the process of going from A to B, some energy left the system. In other words, another way I would say it is that it's not closed. That energy left during the collision in the form of heat. Yeah. So, you know, it's one of those things. This is the reason, this is a common physics example. Every physics book will have this question in it, because it actually has two ideas in it, and it's not so obvious as well, because it's easy to make a mistake like that you did. So this is a classic physics problem. It's called the ballistic pendulum. You'll see it in every physics book, in every good physics book. And if you're wondering, will they ask on the exam? They probably won't, because they've already asked it in the past. So, I mean, they could re-ask it, but it has been asked already. Okay, so what else? We'll probably get one more short question in. A simple question, if you have any more.
Oh, a simple question.
Oh, good, you have more?
Hold on. No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Anything else then? No questions? I can do it. But a bit like with the weight question, these are longer questions. You mean you want to do... Yeah. Is it the last one on that page? The one that has like 10 parts in it? Oh, okay, alright. This topic is a bit confusing. Yeah. You can. Now, what we can do next week is I can do one of those and I'll do that weight and drag. I didn't want to do it today because I did so much of it last week. I think like most of the class last week was weight and drag, if I remember correctly. Yeah. Did you not have any trouble with the projectile lesson? Because nobody's asked me to do a projectile question, except for the one with the cannon, but that was a work question, really. Yeah, I would have thought so. It's the number 6, the one on the hill. The last one.
The one that you
say
the
XX is. Yes, okay.
I couldn't touch this part.
No, I don't understand the kids.
It's not helpful.
Why do you think of this is this game as a fine
thing? Okay. I think next week I'll do the weight and drag, I'll do a rocket one, and I'll do that projectile one. Is there anything else, Dan? Because I don't think, what do we do this week? Conservation of energy, that was okay. Conservation of momentum, I think that one was okay. Power, yeah, that's not too bad. Although, maybe there's one or two in it that's a bit hard.
Really tight.
Yeah. Anyway, we can do more next week, okay? I think I'll see you again at 4 o'clock for the assessment support,
yeah.
Right? Are you in this room, or? You have to leave now?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll do more next week. It makes teacher worried when not many people have many questions. Then I'm left thinking, are they trying the questions?
Trying?
Mm. You know, if students don't have questions, it means they're really smart, or they're not doing the homework. Well, you see, this is what I think sometimes. Okay, we'll leave it there. I'll see you later.